Hello all! So, how do we generate electricity? Well, there are two ways in broad theory. Photovoltaic panels, which take energy from the sun, and the latter which comes from rotational movement. That is water flowing from a hydroelectric plant, wind driving through turbines, and thermal and nuclear plants. But there are many other unexpected methods to generate electricity. And today, we will explore those roads less taken. But before we get started, do not forget to like and subscribe below. Didn't expect that, did you? Ah, you probably did. Before we get into the unexpected, let's go over the basics. In regards to physics, there are six ways to generate electricity. The first is magnetism, when a coil rotates in a magnetic field and produces voltage through a wire. The voltage is then collected, applied to a closed circuit, and generates induced current. This is how AC electricity powers large-scale energy plants. Voltage can be created by the chemical reaction of two metals which transfer electricity between them. This is called a battery. You guessed it. But what else generates chemical electricity? Try the human body. Light produces voltage when it shines on photosensitive material such as photovoltaic panels. This method follows the principles of photoelectricity and uses photons to remove electrons from a material matrix. Number 4. Friction produces voltage by rubbing certain materials together. That is when we feel the sting of static. Squeezing certain crystals, like quartz, produces piezoelectricity. This phenomenon is used for audio technology such as microphones and loudspeakers. With thermoelectricity, which is present in certain materials, heat pushes electrical current. There it is, our six steps to physics, wonderful ways to generate electricity. What's next? Let's get creative. Certain materials become polarized when subjected to mechanical stress, accumulating an electric charge. A familiar application of this method would be the gas lighter. This is one of many examples where no external electric connection is required. But how to use piezoelectricity to collect energy on a larger scale? A few startups have developed podoelectric pavements, such as the Vina in Toulouse, France. Here, there are spring-mounted slabs implanted in the ground. They recover kinetic energy from those who walk atop them. The electricity can then be used to power LED streetlights or other public utilities. 50 tiles with 3,600 people working on them can produce 500 watt-hours that could light an LED street lamp for 10 hours. Another fun experiment was the Paris Marathon of 2013, where piezoelectric tiles were installed along the Champs-Élysées. It is estimated that the kinetic energy generated was more than 7 kilowatt-hours. This amount of energy could recharge 2,000 smartphones. Wow! Why don't we have these panels everywhere? Maybe one day. Do you hear that? Sheesh, the weather in Paris. Good thing I brought my umbrella. But did you know that electricity can be generated from rainfall through friction and pressure? When water drops or slides over a surface, it leaves traces of an electrical charge. From the discoveries by Max Planck and the Institute for Polymer Research, there are now methods to quantify the charge for generation. Researchers have developed surfaces that amplify the effect to collect more electricity. Another concept: using piezoelectric sensors to convert the impact of raindrop energy into electric power. The City University of Hong Kong has created a device that allows for such a conversion. The droplet-based electricity generator, the EEG, harnesses rain at a level of efficiency that makes the system practical. With it, researchers can take two water drops, or 100 microliters, released at a height of 15 centimeters and generate 140 volts. That is enough to illuminate 100 LED light bulbs. Imagine covering such devices across a roof and the coming of a good storm. The amount of electricity that could be gathered. Let it rain, let it rain! Wait, where is my umbrella? Ouch! Just kidding. But is it possible to generate electricity from air? In fact, it is! The Monash University of Biomedicine in Melbourne, Oxford Biochemistry, and Queen's College have together modeled the behavior of an enzyme produced by a soil bacterium known as Mycobacterium smegmatis. This enzyme uses low amounts of hydrogen found in the atmosphere to create currents. The enzyme, known as HUC, is so efficient it can consume hydrogen below atmospheric levels. And like many other bacteria, it uses hydrogen as an energy source. But the difference with good old HUC is that it can sustain electrical current from air. HUC and enzymes like it could be grown in large quantities. So with this discovery, there is considerable potential to develop small air-powered devices, which could be a great alternative to solar. Ah, a football or soccer ball, whatever. In 2009, a Harvard student by the name of Jessica Matthews gathered four friends to file a patent for the socket. Taking a ball like this and adding a built-in battery, she connected the world's most popular game to electricity generation. When being kicked and bounced across the field, her ball absorbs kinetic energy, charging the battery within it. The ball can then be connected to LEDs and provide lighting. Jessica, with roots in Nigeria, wished to improve the lives of those in developing countries and found an inspiring way to do so. She earned several awards, the 10 most powerful women entrepreneurs and scientists of the year, to name a few. I'll never play in the Lens football club, not like this. But hey, we can dream. Imagine all the unique ways we can generate electricity through marine bacteria, jellyfish, solar wind and noise, speed bumps and belts. The possibilities are endless. There are six physical ways to generate electricity, with magnetism, chemical, light, friction, pressure and heat. To gather energy, piezoelectricity has been embedded in pavement in high pedestrian traffic areas. Electricity can be generated from rain via DEG or droplet-based electricity generators. Electricity can be generated from air via the HUC. Electricity can even be generated from sports via kinetic energy. All right, on second thought, I think I'm ready to join for the Lens Club. When are the next tryouts? Okay, fine, I'll stick to science. But to think an object like this can be used to make life better on two different levels, to bring the joy of sport, to generate light. Do you have any new methods to generate electricity? If so, do not hesitate to leave a comment below. This is Frédéric, tuning out!